take a break. Good evening. I'm Jules Marquardt. And on behalf of the League of Women Voters, I'd like to welcome you to this candidates forum for three races.
One meeting, guys. Thank you. Thank you.
This is one way that the League informs and encourages voters. We would like to thank these citizens who are willing to serve in elective office. We also thank the Fairdale Library for its generosity in providing this facility. And of course, we thank all of you for coming. This is a great turnout. Tonight, first we will hear from the candidates for Metro Council District 13, Jennifer Alexander and Mark Fox. Then, we may do some switching around, but the second forum will be for the Kentucky House of Representatives District 37, incumbent Jeff Donahue and Catherine Sweeten Windsor. And then after that, we will meet the candidates for the Kentucky Senate District 38, incumbent Dan Syme, Andrew Bailey, and Brenda Board. Let me go over the ground rules for the forum. Please turn off all cell phones. We have given WLKY permission to stream the debates, but otherwise video and audio recording are not allowed. No one is allowed to use footage from this forum for their campaign purposes. We ask that the audience refrain from clapping or showing favorites in any way during the actual forum. You'll have a chance to do that at the end. Each forum will last 30 minutes. Each candidate will have the opportunity to give a 90-second opening statement. Then I will be posing questions to them. They'll have 1 minute to give their response. And then each candidate will have a 90-second closing statement. We have timekeepers here in the front row. When you have 30 seconds remaining, the timekeeper will hold up a card. When you have 15 seconds remaining, you'll see, get that card. And when you have 0 seconds remaining, they will hold up the stop sign. And of course, you don't have to use your full 60 seconds. Candidates are permitted to take notes and use notes during the forum, but they may not use phones, display charts, or props of any kind. So we have flipped the coin, and for the Metro Council District 13 race, Jennifer will go first with her opening statement.
Great. Thank you. Stand up. Okay. So thank you guys for coming out. I appreciate it. I just want to spend a minute or two, 90 seconds actually, to tell you a little bit about myself. I grew up in the district. I was born here, grew up here. I have generations of family that have been in this district, so I've got deep ties in our district. I'm a product of our JCPS school system. I graduated as valedictorian from Fairdale High School, and then went on to University of Louisville on a Governor Scholar Scholarship. In 5 years, I graduated with 3 degrees. I have a bachelor and master's degree in chemical engineering, as well as a master's in business administration. I've worked for the same company in private industry for 18 years in increasing leadership roles. And then on the personal side of things, I have 2 amazing children who are also in our JCPS school system. One is at Fairdale Elementary and one's at Farnsley Middle School. I often get asked why I'm running for Metro Council, and the answer is easy. I just want to make a difference. My family taught me the value of giving back to the community, and I think that the best way to do that is through involvement. And I do that in many ways, one of which is sitting on the site-based decision-making council at both of my kids' schools. District 13 needs bold leadership with no ties to current administration, and that's what I bring to the district. So I'm looking for your support, and thank you guys again for coming out.
Mark? Well, thank you for coming, and thank you to the League and to the Fairdale Library for hosting this forum. I, too, was born and raised in South Louisville and have lived in this district for over 25 years. I've spent my lifetime preparing for this job interview, as a matter of fact. I'm new to politics, but I'm not new to public service, having served 30 years as a police officer and as a police executive in our community. I have a record of lowering crime, increasing the quality of life, leading people, managing budgets. I've dealt with our community's toughest issues under the scope of public scrutiny. I see the good in our community, and I have the vision and have established the relationships to make it even better. I've stood in hundreds of porches over the last year and a half. I've attended zoning board hearings. I've attended neighborhood meetings that involve development, and I've taken notes along the way. I enjoy tremendous bipartisan support. I have the support of law enforcement, fire, auto workers, and 14 organizations that are in my book for your review. That support also includes our teachers. We trust our children every day with our teachers, and our teachers trust me with their community's future. I also want to restore civility to the political process. The issues we have are nonpartisan, as are the solutions. I want your vote on November 6th, and I'll work hard every day to give us a community of which we can all be proud.
Okay. For the first question, it will go to Mark. What is the single greatest need in District 13, and what will you do as a council member to fulfill it?
I think our single greatest need is improving the quality of life and reestablishing our neighborhood identities. We have issues that fall under the heading of quality of life, and they involve crime, they involve the opioid epidemic, they involve drainage. They involve development that we don't want. We need to rebuild, we need to retool, and we need to look at getting our neighborhoods family friendly again, where we look out for one another and we take care of each other. The